केजीबीवी विद्यालय स्टार्टेड ऑनलाइन क्लासेस फॉर यू इट इज वेरी यूजफुल टू यू स्टूडेंट्स ऑल ऑफ यू लिसन केयरफुली एंड नोट डाउन द ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट दिस इज कोविड पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन डोंट गो टू योर रिलेटिव स्टे होम एंड स्टे सेफ Let us see the next lesson. Before going to the today lesson, I will ask some questions. What is the name of our lesson? Yesterday lesson, what is the name of our last class lesson? Students? Very good. Really India? Really futures. How many parallel ranges are in Himalayas? Very nice. Three parallel ranges. One is Himadri or Greater Himalayas. Second one is Himalayas or Lesser Himalayas. Third one is Shivaliks. How many relief divisions in our country? Very good. Six divisions in our country. Already we know the Himalayas and Indo-Gangetic Plains. Today, in this class, we see the Peninsular Plateau. Students, Peninsular Plateau is also called as the Indian Plateau. Here, Peninsular Plateau formed from the Gondwana land. This Peninsular Plateau divided into two types. One is Malwa Plateau, another one is Deccan Plateau. Students, Peninsular Plateau is divided into two plateaus. One is Malwa Plateau, another one is Deccan Plateau. Now, we see the peninsular importance of the Peninsular Plateau and the formation of Peninsular Plateau. Here, Peninsular Plateau formed from Gondwana land. This Peninsular Plateau is the largest one and oldest one. This Peninsular Plateau has three sides of water. Students, all of you look at the India map. This is India map here. Students, observe carefully. This is the Peninsular Plateau. Peninsular Plateau. This Peninsular Plateau divided into two types. This is Malwa Plateau. Another one is Deccan Plateau. Here, Peninsular Plateau has three sides of the water. Students, observe carefully. Here, Bay of Bengal. Here, Indian Ocean. Here, Arabian Sea. Arabian Sea. Bay of Bengal in the east direction of the Peninsular Plateau. Arabian Sea in the west direction of the Peninsular Plateau. Indian Ocean is south direction of the Peninsular Plateau. Why we call it the Peninsular Plateau? Already we learned the last lesson. This region has three sides of the water and one side of the land. This is called as the peninsula. Here, this Peninsular Plateau has three sides of the water. Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean. That's why we called the this plateau name is Peninsular Plateau. Next, this peninsular plateau has crystalline rocks, hard igneous rocks, metamorphic rocks. This peninsular plateau has this type of hard rocks. Next, this peninsular plateau formed due to volcanic eruption. The peninsular plateau famous for black soils. Black soil is suitable for black soils are very useful to the cotton crop. Next, this Peninsular Plateau consists metallic and non-metallic minerals. So, this Peninsular Plateau slightly tilted towards the east side. Children, this is Peninsular Plateau. This Peninsular Plateau slightly tilted towards the east direction. Students, all of you observe. This is the east direction. This is the west direction. Here, just imagine here Deccan Peninsula Plateau is formed. This is the slightly tilted. This peninsular plateau slightly tilted to east direction. This is tilted, slightly tilted position. In this way, many of the rivers, main rivers, Godavari, Krishna rivers are flowing into the eastwards and finally joining into the Bay of Bengal. Here, this peninsular plateau slightly tilted towards the eastwards. Here, Godavari river, Krishna river, here Kaveri river. These rivers are flowing into eastwards and finally joining into the Bay of Bengal. Next, we see the Malwa. We see the importance of the Malwa plateau, where it is located. Children, carefully observe in this India map. It is a Malwa plateau. Here, Indo-Gangetic Plains. Malwa plateau is middle of the Indo-Gangetic Plains and Vindhya Range. Here, Vindhya Ranges it is a Narmada river. Narmada river, Narmada. Malwa plateau is also known as the central highlands. Here in the east direction, Chota Nagpur Plateau is located. Here it is a Chota Nagpur Plateau. It is very famous for rich minerals. This is also called as the heart of our India because of the so many mineral resources are there here available. These mineral resources are developed to the our Indian economy. That's why we called the Chota Nagpur Plateau is a heart of India. Students, look at the careful in this board. Here, Malwa Plateau, Indo-Gangetic Plains are northern boundary. Here, Malwa Plateau, Chota Nagpur lies in the east of the Malwa Plateau.
Indo-Gangetic Plains are north boundary of Malwa Plateau. Vindhya Narmada rivers are south boundary of Malwa Plateau. Northwest Aravali ranges are formed. Chota Nagpur Plateau is formed in eastern boundary of Malwa Plateau.
Children, let us see the second one is the Deccan Plateau. Here it is a Deccan Plateau is a triangle shape. Deccan Plateau is a triangle shape. Here we see the boundaries of Deccan Plateau. Here Tapi River. It is also called as the Tapati River. Tapati or Tapi River. Here Satpura ranges are there. Satpura ranges are located in this area. Tapi River and Satpura rivers are boundaries, north boundary of Deccan Plateau. Here these are Eastern Ghats. Eastern Ghats lies in the east direction of Deccan Plateau. It is a Deccan Plateau. Deccan Plateau. These Eastern Ghats. Eastern Ghats. Eastern Ghats lies in the east direction of the Deccan Plateau. Here, Western Ghats. These are Western Ghats. Western Ghats lies in the west direction of the Deccan Plateau. Here, Tapi River or Satpura ranges are lies in the north direction of Deccan Plateau. Here, These western ghats are continuously formed ranges. These western ghats stretched from Maharashtra to Kerala. Let us see once again in this peninsular plateau, students. Peninsular plateau also called as the Indian plateau. This divided into two plateaus, Malwa plateau and Deccan plateau. This is formed from Gondwana land. It is longest one and oldest one. This peninsular plateau has three sides of the water. This peninsular plateau has crystalline rocks, hard igneous rocks, metamorphic rocks. In this peninsular plateau formed due to the volcanic eruptions. In this peninsular plateau, black soils are very famous to cotton crop. Here, this peninsular plateau consists of metallic and non-metallic minerals. In this peninsular plateau, slightly towards the eastwards. That's why our peninsular rivers are flowing into the eastwards and finally joining into the Bay of Bengal. Students, are you clear in this peninsular plateau? Okay. Next, we see what are the importance in this peninsular plateau. This peninsular plateau not suitable for agriculture. Not suitable to agriculture because of this peninsular plateau consists with hard rocks. That's why this is not suitable for agriculture. Here, peninsular plateau that did not have any perennial rivers. Perennial rivers means perennial rivers flowing throughout the year, did not dry up. Here, peninsular plateau has only peninsular rivers. For example, Godavari River and Krishna, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri rivers. Here, these rivers did not flowing in summer season. These rivers are dry up. Here, perennial rivers did not dry up. These perennial rivers formed in Himalayan ranges. So, this peninsular plateau did not have any perennial rivers. But, it is, peninsular plateau is very important, very famous to rich minerals. Here, southmost tip of India, Kanyakumari is southernmost tip of India. Here, three water bodies are there, Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea and Indian Ocean. These are joining to each other in this Kanyakumari. This is also called as the southernmost tip of India. Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. Formation of Western Ghats, formation of Eastern Ghats. What is the difference between Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats? These things are you learn in this class. Here, Western Ghats. Children, all of you look at the board. These are Western Ghats. Western Ghats stretched from Maharashtra. Maharashtra to Kerala. Here, these Western Ghats formed parallel to Western coast. Children, all of you look at the board carefully. These are plains. These are West Coast plains. The Western Ghats form parallel to Western plains. Here, Western Ghats elevation is 2000 meters height. Western Ghats height is 2000 meters height. Western Ghats extend for 1600 kilometers. These Western Ghats extend from Maharashtra to Kerala 600 kilometers. 600 kilometers. This western ghats higher than the eastern ghats. Students, look here. These are eastern ghats. Western ghats higher than the eastern ghats. Here, western ghats, some important hill station is there. That is Udagamandalam or Ooty. Udagamandalam is also called as the Ooty. Ooty is located in Nilagiri Ranges. Here, in these western ghats, some important hilly regions are there. Anaimalai and Kardamom Hills. Anaimalai and Kardamom Hills located in Kerala state. Here, in Nilagiri, Dodabetta Peak is highest peak in western Ghats. Dodabetta Peak height is 2,637 meters height. Here, one of the important point is in Anaimalai hilly regions, Anaimudi Peak is the highest peak in South India. Anaimudi Peak height is 2,695 meters height. Here, Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats joining in this Nilagiri ranges, especially at Gudaluru. Here, Gudaluru. Gudaluru. These Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats are joining into the Gudaluru, at Gudaluru in Nilagiri ranges. Next, we see the Eastern Ghats. Here, Eastern Ghats are parallel to the East Coastal Plains. Students, carefully observe in this board. These are Eastern Coastal Plains. Eastern Coastal Plains lies east side of the Eastern Ghats. Here, Eastern Ghats are parallel to the East Plains. Here, why this is not parallel, this is not a continuity in the Eastern Ghats? One is the most reason is the here Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri rivers are originated from Western Ghats. Here, these peninsular rivers are flowing into the eastwards. These rivers are cutting down the hilly region in Eastern Ghats. That's why these Eastern Ghats are not continuity. Here, Eastern Ghats are lesser than the Western Ghats. Eastern Ghats height is 900 meters height. Western Ghat height is 2000 meters height. Here, Eastern Ghat height is 900 meters height. Here, various hilly regions in Eastern Ghats. They are Nallamalas, Veligondas, Palakondas, Seshachalas formed in the Eastern Ghats. These are important ranges in Eastern Ghats. Here, one of the most important point is one of the most peak in Eastern Ghats. That is Aroya Konda. Aroya Konda located at Sindapalli in Eastern Ghats. Aroya Konda peak height is 1,680 meters height. These are the differences between Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. The Thar Desert. Thar Desert is also known as the Indian Desert or Great Indian Desert. Thar Desert located in Rajasthan state. Students, all of you look at the board carefully. Here, Thar Desert. It is located in western part of the Rajasthan and a small portion in Haryana. Rajasthan lies in two states. Most of the western Rajasthan, second one is the little portion of the Haryana state. Here, this Indian Desert is located in leeward side of the Aravali. Children, look this. These are Aravali Mountains. Aravali Mountains. The Thar Desert located leeward side of Aravali Ranges. Here arid climate. Very low rainfall is recorded in Thar Desert. It is called as arid climate. Here yearly 100 to 150 millimeters rainfall is recorded. It is very low rainfall. Here no vegetation is there. When this place is have low rainfall, that region has no vegetation. Here no low vegetation. Here some streams appear in rainy season, after disappear soon after. Here some rainy season streams are appear in rainy season, disappear soon after. Here Rajasthani's occupation is mostly rearing animals and maintain the shops, hotels. Here important towns are there in Rajasthan: Jaipur, Ajmer, Jodhpur, Bikaner. Towns are famous in Rajasthan. Here highest temperature recorded in Jaipur town. Here Rajasthan in the Thar Desert has a rocky undulating sand plains are there. This is the vast portion of the Thar Desert. Here there is no sufficient rainfall, there is no sufficient vegetation. High temperature is recorded in this Thar Desert. Here only one longest canal is the Indira Gandhi Canal. It goes to 650 kilometers. This Indira Gandhi Canal started from Satluj River. Satluj River located in Punjab state. This is only one of the Indira Gandhi Canal is only one of the source to provide the drinking water and irrigation water to the Rajasthanis. Here we see the once again situation of the Thar Desert. This is the Thar Desert is only one desert in our Indian country. Here Thar Desert located in Rajasthan. Most of the place occupation is western Rajasthan. Only small portion is Haryana. Here this Thar Desert located in leeward side of the Aravali Mountains. Here low rainfall recorded, that is annual rainfall is 100 to 150 millimeters rainfall. Here low vegetation. Here some streams appear in rainy season and they soon disappear soon after. Here occupation, Rajasthani's occupation is animal rearing and maintain the shops and hotels also. Here famous towns are there, famous cities are there: Jaipur, Ajmer, Jodhpur, Bikaner. These are important famous cities in Rajasthan. Here only one canal is flowing into the Rajasthan and give to the drinking water and irrigation water to the Rajasthanis. The longest canal is Indira Gandhi Canal. That canal goes to the 650 kilometers. This Indira Gandhi Canal started from Satluj River. This is located in Punjab state. Students, let us see the coastal plains. These coastal plains are divided into two types: west coastal plains, east coastal plains. Here we know the west coastal plains. Here these are west coastal plains. West coastal plains are stretched from Ran of Kutch to Kanyakumari. Here these western coastal plains are narrower than compared to the eastern coastal plains. Here these western coastal plains are uneven and broken by the western ghats. Here These western coastal plains are divided into three types. One is Konkan coast, Kenara coast and Malabar coast. Konkan coast belongs to the Maharashtra and Goa. Maharashtra and Goa. Here, children, all of you look at the board carefully. These are west coastal plains. It is a Maharashtra state. It is a Goa. Goa, it is a Karnataka state. Here, the Konkan coast, it is a southern part of the western coastal plains. It is a southern part of the western coastal plains. This western coastal plains formed in Maharashtra, Goa. These are called in Konkan coast. And different states called in different names. Here, Maharashtra, Goa called this western plains by the Konkan coast. It is a Konkan coast. Konkan coast belongs to the Maharashtra and Goa. Next, Kenara. Kenara coast. Kenara coast lies in the middle of the western eastern plains. It is Kenara coast is belongs to the Karnataka state. Next, Malabar. Malabar coastal plains are belongs to the Kerala. It is the northmost of the western Ghats. This place is, children, look this. This place is northernmost of the western coastal plains. It is a southernmost of the western coastal plains. It is a middle of the western coastal plains. Western coastal plains are divided into three types. One is Konkan coast belongs to Maharashtra and Goa. Kenara coast belongs to Karnataka. Malabar coast belongs to the Kerala. Okay, students. Next, we will go to the eastern coastal plains. Children, look this board. These are coastal plains. These are coastal plains. These are broader than western coastal plains. These are broader than western coastal plains. These eastern coastal plains stretched from the Mahanadi River to Kaveri River in Tamil Nadu. Eastern coastal plains are stretched from Mahanadi River from Odisha to Kaveri River to Tamil Nadu. These eastern coastal plains are very broader. Here, in this eastern coastal plains are divided into three types of coastal plains. East coastal plains are this. This is Utkal coast. Utkal coast belongs to the Odisha. This is Odisha state. Utkal coast called by the Odisha. Here, Sarkar coast. It is a AP state. Sarkar coast belongs to the AP state. Here, Coromandel coast. Coromandel coast belongs to the Tamil Nadu state. Here, these are very important to the public examination. Western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains. Konkan coast belongs to the Maharashtra and Goa. Kenara coast belongs to the Karnataka. Malabar coast belongs to the Tamil Nadu. Here, eastern coastal plains. These are Utkal coast belongs to the Odisha. Sarkar coast belongs to the Andhra Pradesh. Coromandel coast belongs to the Tamil Nadu. These are the coastal plains. Next, we see the uses of coastal plains. These coastal plains are very fertile in western coastal plains and eastern coastal plains are very fertile. These are useful to the agricultural sector. These coastal plains very fertile. Here, why these are very fertile? Because of the here, some important rivers are flowing. Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri rivers are flowing into the eastern plains and formed the fertile plains. Here, some important lakes are there. Here, next one is, another one is, rich fishing resources are there in the coastal plains. Here, some important lakes are there. Chilika Lake in Odisha. Kolleru and Pulikat lakes in Andhra Pradesh. Kolleru lake is a salty water lake. Pulikat lake is a good drinking water facility. So these are coastal plains and uses of coastal plains. Let us see the island. The island. Our India has two groups of islands. One is Lakshadweep. Second one is Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Now we locate the in India map. Here Lakshadweep. These are Lakshadweep. Lakshadweep Islands.
Lakshadweep Islands located in Arabian Sea. And Andaman Nicobar Islands located in Bay of Bengal.
Now let us see the Lakshadweep Islands. Lakshadweep Islands are coral origin. These Lakshadweep Islands origin from coral relief. Here geographic are 32 square kilometers. Lakshadweep famous for great variety of flora and fauna. It is very famous for great variety of flora and fauna. Here, what is mean by island? Now, we explain the island. Which region has four sides of the water? This is called as the island. Children, look this. Our India, we called the peninsular India. Why we say the peninsula, why we called the peninsular of India? Because of the India has three sides of the water. That's why we called the peninsular of India. Here, island. Island has four sides of the water. East, west, north side. Islands surrounded by four sides of the water. That's why we say the islands are islands. This is the difference between peninsula and island. Here we go to next one is Andaman Nicobar Islands. These are Andaman. In the above Andaman and in the down these are Nicobar Islands. These are Andaman Nicobar Islands lies east direction of the India. Here. This is the last one. Andaman Nicobar Islands, this is the last one. This is the southernmost tip of India found in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Here, this is also called as the Indira Point. Indira Point was a submerged during in 2004 tsunami. Here, these two islands are very important to our country. Children, let us see the in this lesson important of map finding Mount Everest and Great Peaks, important of rivers we are located in India map. Children, all of you look at the map carefully. This is Mount Everest. This is Mount Everest. 8,845.48 meters height. Mount Everest has 8,848 meters height. Everest is the highest Everest in the world. Highest peak in the world. Here it is a K2 peak. K2 peak is highest peak in our India. Next, it is a Kanchenjunga. Located in Sikkim. Located in Sikkim state. Next, already we say the Anaimuri Peak. Anaimuri Peak belongs to the Anaimalai Hills. Anaimuri Peak height is the 2,695 meters height. These are important peaks in our country. Next, we see the relief divisions in our country. These are already we say that these are Himalaya ranges. Three parallel ranges. Greater Himalaya, Lesser Himalaya, Shivalik. These are. Next. Here, this is Indo-Gangetic Plain. These are Indo-Gangetic Plain. Next one. Here, it is a Thar Desert. Thar Desert. Next one is Peninsula Plateau. It is a Peninsula Plateau. West direction, western ghats. East direction, lies in the eastern side of the India. Next, these are plains. Eastern coastal plains, western coastal plains. Here, two groups of islands are there. One is Lakshadweep Island, another one is Andaman Nicobar Islands. So these are the important to the India and the relief features. Students, all of you carefully observe. See again and again and learn. These are very important to map pointing. Thank you, children.
Today, homework is identify the major relief divisions in India map.